Hi everybody and welcome to RAF Valley. Today I'm flying the Red Arrows Hawk over to RAF Shawbury, a flight of around 20 minutes. This is the recently released Just Flight Hawk T1 for Microsoft Flight Simulator. The plan for today's flight is to fly over to Shawbury VFR with an instrument approach and landing. Overseeing the flight today is the instructor in the back seat. Turning the takeoff roll, get the pressure off the nose wheel early, and it should lift up around 120 knots. Gear up. Flaps up. Throttling back now to around 90%.
Valley approach Red 6 Tango Alpha is type British Aerospace, about 3 miles southeast of Valley 2400. Request flight following.
Red 6 Tango Alpha Valley approach.
Squawk 3532. Squawk 3532 Red 6 Tango Alpha.
I've now got around 2 hours flight time in the Hawk, and my only criticism is that it's very, very twitchy on the elevator control, which makes landing and takeoff quite difficult. Other than that, the handling is quite superb. Departing Valley from runway 13, now setting a track 115 degrees to take me north of Shawbury for a direct approach onto runway 18. Leaving RAF Valley area now in the Isle of Anglesey. Just about to cross over the Menai Strait. We'll see how she handles me. Slow roll.
Cruising along at 380 knots. During the flight, keeping clear of cloud to maintain VFR. above the canopy there of Puffin Island. And there is the Conway estuary and the great hall of Llandudno. This is great fun. Just past Lyn Brannig Reservoir and started a shallow descent now into position north of Shawbury. Approach at Shawbury, I'm using the ILS DME for runway 18. Initially positioning 12 miles to the north at 3,000 feet with an inbound track of 184 degrees, which is 3 degrees offset from the runway centre line. The instrument I'm using is the middle lower dial, which is the HSI, tuned in to 110.75, and the localizer pointer needle dialed into 184 degrees. The top left of the instrument shows the distance to run to the airfield, and on the dial the green arrow at the top right actually points to the airfield. The middle left of the instrument there's a little circle we call the donut, and you keep that centred on the glide slope to maintain the proper glide slope of 3 degrees down to the runway threshold. This approach looks like proper India Mike Charlie. I should really turn off the GPS when practicing an instrument landing, but what the hell. Below 200 knots, flaps down. The localizer needle's moving in now, so I'll turn in towards the field. As the localizer needle begins to center, I'll make a right turn to maintain 185 degrees on the localizer. Nicely centered on the localizer, turning into 185 degrees. A little high. Overshooting a bit, bringing it back. Precision height is 580 feet. four flap. Maintaining a radial scan from the HSI with the artificial horizon, speed, power, rate of descent and heading. Nothing focuses the mind more than instrument flying, especially as you get near the ground. Knots. Above the center line, continue with the landing. Power to idle. Hold her off. Hold her off. Go back on the runway. Nose wheel planted. Brake. It's a long time since I've done that for real. Not the best of landings. All in all, a very nice aircraft. I hope you enjoyed the flight, and join me again next time. Thanks for watching.